Situated in 700 acres of beautiful North Herefordshire countryside, Witton Farm is a working farm that grows fruit for some of the most famous drinks brands in the UK. They also produce their very own blackcurrant cassis liqueur, which usually originates in France. Drew's been invited to explore the outbuildings, which contain surplus items from the estate's original country house that has since been demolished. The farm has been in Joe Hilditch's family for over 150 years.
Hi, Joe.
Hello.
How are you doing? Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you.
And you?
Well,
what a place.
I know. Welcome to the Witton.
So today is very unusual, not what I would normally expect to find in Herefordshire, a cassis distillery. We roll up into this absolutely sublime scene. I think we could have been in the rolling hills of Italy, but no, we're in Hereford. So this is where the magic
happens.
This is
where it happens.
Love and the branding and the bottles you've used.
They're really good, aren't
really
they?
Nice.
You go on the machine.
So just whip that one out. Shine the light.
I can supply you with a few more.
You're a natural drink.
This is good, isn't it?
Sure
it's like it's like watching my life in rewind.
It's not going to get the prize for speed.
Yeah.
Slow and steady wins the race.
So one a week.
It's like milking a great big blackcurrant cow, isn't it? It's brilliant. So how many of these do you do a day? Thousands of them, I suppose.
I suppose we could do about 1,000.
So long as Drew's not here.
I don't think I need to give up my day job. I think I was far too slow after watching the two young guys doing it. But yeah, what I did like about it was the branding. It was extremely classy and not shouty. Excellent, right. But I do believe I've got to do my proper job now.
Come on then, let's
get some stuff for me to look at. Right. So what's this, like a sheep barn?
It's a sheep barn. It used to be a sheep dipping barn.
And this is the bits you want to get rid of, potentially?
Potentially. It's just been used as a dumping ground for lots of bits and pieces for years. Now, that's sat in a junk box for many long years.
So the electrified oil lamp in a nice base, actually.
Is it?
Yeah, it's all right, that. It's okay. The lamp is one of those things that I'm going to have to spend some money on, but it's more time. The rewire is going to take minutes and cost a few pounds. We've got the materials, we do it in-house. The cleaning of it is slightly trickier, so not over-egg it, overdo it, basically. The base is good, and I don't want to clean that too much and lose that patination that it's taken decades, you know, to acquire.
Made in the late 19th century, the base of this lamp is Japanese in origin and still bears traces of the original gilt finish. Originally an oil-burning lamp, over the years it has been repaired and converted to gas, and more recently electricity. Carefully and sympathetically restored, it could be worth around £550.
A big crack in it there. Great big crack all the way around there.
What about all the other cracks?
This is sort of crazing that one to the glaze.
Is it painted? Or?
It's hand-painted, yeah.
Yeah.
So it's a 19th century or earlier vase,
mm-hmm.
and lastly converted to oil and then converted to electric. It's actually quite nice.
Is it?
Yeah. I think you're looking at it with different eyes now, aren't you?
Yeah,
I thought so.
It's just been languishing.
But for that little thing, even with the crack, I'll happily give you £300.
A little bit more?
I've just remembered, Ron, is your father a farmer?
Yeah, I'm the farmer.
It's always farmers, isn't it? Yeah. Always farmers, you're always...
You've got no chance. You've lost already.
All right, £350, that's it, done, finito.
Okay.
Deal?
Yeah.
Thank you. It's very nice, but that could have easily got thrown away, couldn't it?
It could have.
Yeah. Price-wise, paid £350. Let's say in time and effort and materials, we're going to spend £50-60 on it, and it should retail between £550, somewhere around there. We're not making a fortune on it, but it doesn't matter. We'll have a very nice, happy customer, that's for sure. You had a big house around here, didn't you?
Yeah.
It was demolished, so that would have come from there?
I think so, yeah. I think that would have been one of the only things that was retained.
Probably. What about
and
this?
And that, and I think that too.
This one is not worth as much as that.
Yeah.
Even though they're quite common, it is on leather.
But it's never... I've never seen a use for it.
They look really good hung on a wall. That's the only thing you can really do with
them. OK, well, that's giving me a new idea with that.
Oh, bugger.
Before you go and offer me something silly.
It's that's what I do with them. And then it gives them a sort of another life, really.
Because you'd never use it as a screen now, would you? Unless you have a stripper in your dining room or something like that.
Ideally.
You've got loads, haven't you?
I'm having the pole fitted at the weekend, actually. I think it's upside down as well. Well, it is upside down. I'm going to flip it round. It can't be upside down because the frame's like that.
Oh, well, maybe they put it on the...
My grandfather
put it on the thing the wrong way up.
It's the wrong way up.
So that's hand-painted on leather.
So what they do first is they make all these shapes into the leather, and then it's painted and gilt. And this has been over-painted as well. It's unusual in two respects. One, I think the embossed leather is upside down. And number two, it's only twofold, which is really unusual. They're usually 3-4 minimum, so a little double one. And it hasn't been trimmed down either. That's how it's always been.
Leather screens were a popular addition to European homes from the 17th to early 20th centuries. Originally designed for privacy, they were also decorative and often featured motifs such as birds or floral arrangements. This one was made in around 1860 and has a gilded design with hand-painted flowers. It could be worth around £550.
What about a bid the same as the lamp, £350?
What would you sell it for?
£550.
So then you should go to 400, really?
Ideally not, no. I need to make some profit. That's what I see it on the shop floor at 550, because it's got a couple. It is a little odd that it appears to be upside down.
So what did you say? 375, was it? I am a farmer, remember.
I know. 375, fine, sold. I'll take it. Paid £375 for the screen in the end. That's fine. We've got a little bit of work to it, not much. We'll hang it on a wall and it'll retail well. £450, £500, somewhere around there, I think. Well, there you go. I can see something already in there, like the chair in the far right corner.
The one in the cane one?
Yeah.
Yeah. It used to sit in my granny's dressing room. There's where you put on. I think
I'm more interested in what's inside it.
I think it's green, as far as I remember.
Because it changes the value if it's got the original seat cover. See? It's been sat in underneath a dripping tap by the looks of it. Yeah, that's the original. That's the original cover.
Is it?
Yeah. Needs work, again. This needs completely repolishing. It's gone very,
yeah,
very flat.
Yeah.
There's a big lump being chipped out of it there and then stuck back on. This will sound quite harsh, but in its current state, because of the damage, £150.
Yeah, I think I'd probably hold on to it at that.
Yeah.
The value to me is thinking of my granny sitting in it.
Yeah.
So I really ought to do it up and put it somewhere where you can really notice it.
And there's a few interesting pieces, but there was a Berger armchair there with a really nice, high sort of spoon back to it. But there was a repair on the back, which I can't get away from. And also, Joe has an attachment to it. I never want to take things off people that have that, because that's really what things are really worth.
Having explored the farm and the items Joe has for sale, the boys have been invited to enjoy a special treat before they hit the road.
Good evening, sir.
This looks very nice. So, come on then, talk me through this.
We have a bramble, which is cassis, gin and lime juice, a bit of sugar. What do we think? Is that a winner?
Oh, yeah.
The last one's a Kira Royale.
Which is this one or that one?
This is mine. This is soda water.
Van-friendly.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is very nice. I didn't realise you'd jump ship now.
Oh, yeah, I've been branching out, yeah. The company's much better in this job, I am.
You're sick of driving the van?
Yeah.
That's very good.
Oh, that's actually really good as well. You made a mess there.
The day was so interesting. I never dive in at the first offer. I'm a farmer, so I'm used to wheeler-dealering, and certainly if you come in at one level, I'm definitely going to come in above.
Joe was really nice to deal with all day. The things I bought were great. The screen, fairly standard-ish thing, but super decorative. The buy of the day was the Japanese vase lamp. It's going to need a little bit more work than I thought, but it's quality. All in all, a fabulous day.